All right, it's time for Travel Smart this morning. Some major regions are reopening to tourists in the coming weeks.
That's right, and joining us live to break it all down is Travelzoo. Hey, good morning to you. We love the suit. Is
hey,
that
guys.
Pomegranate?
You know, I call it burgundy, I call it Pinot Noir, depending on the time of day, but I heard it was all about the Sunday best today, so I went digging for this.
He knows.
Yeah. Oh, we appreciate that.
Talk to us. So Canada is set to reopen to American travelers. This is all going down next month. What do we need to know?
Okay, so it's been a long time. March 2020 is when that 5,500-mile U.S.-Canada border shut down. It has been rough going, certainly within Canada, slowly. Some of the restrictions within that country are starting to ease. We're looking now at mid-August for Americans who are fully vaccinated, being able to re-enter Canada, early September for fully vaccinated travelers from other countries as well. Some are saying it's too little too late. That's going to mean basically two full summer seasons, 2020 and 2021, that a lot of these Canadian hospitality companies and hotels will lose out. You know, about 50 million Americans visited Canada in 2019. So certainly, even if we open things back up for Americans mid-next month, we're not going to make up those numbers. However, all that said and done, it is good news. A lot of families, as you know, have been straddling that border and have been unable to visit their family and loved ones on the other side of that border. So mid-August, Canada reopens up to fully vaccinated Americans. And if you're a cruiser, you know that they've also upped the deadline for cruise lines to be able to stop in Canadian ports. It used to be February of next year. Now it's been moved to fall of this year. So slowly but surely, Canada now, with 50% of its residents fully vaccinated, opening back up to Americans and the rest of the world.
Hey, Gabe, let's go across the pond. Tomorrow's reopening of the UK is so big, they even have their own name for it. What's it called?
Yeah, Freedom Day. Yeah, my friends there in the UK are very excited about July 19th. That is Freedom Day out there. They're lifting all of their restrictions in the UK. You can dine inside restaurants without a mask. A lot of the social distancing protocols out the window. If you are a UK resident and you fly internationally, come back to the UK, you don't have to quarantine. Now, for American travelers, there's still some restrictions, some 10-day quarantine-like restrictions, but slowly but surely, Americans are making their way back to the UK. But that's big out there. Tomorrow's Freedom Day in the UK. Tomorrow, guys, also Ireland opening back up to fully vaccinated Americans. That means that if you land starting tomorrow in Ireland, you don't have to quarantine. If you're not vaccinated, you do have to have a negative COVID test. You have to quarantine for 5 days in Ireland. But again, this has been a very long closure. A lot of Americans have, you know, about 70 million Americans it's about 40 million Americans have some degree of Irish heritage flowing through their veins. So the idea of opening up the ROI, Republic of Ireland, up to Americans is a big deal. And of course, this week, guys, is when we expect the Biden administration to announce when the travel ban, restricting travel from Europe to the U.S. will be lifted. We're anticipating that'll happen sometime next month as well. That's a big boon for American cities like New York, like Miami, Southern California. We're going to start to see those Europeans starting to come back our way all over again.
Yeah, Gabe, we're standing by for that. Now, when it comes to top destinations, people who want to book something right now, let's talk about the top three. I want to start with Italy. I hear it's on the list.
Yes. Italy's always a favorite. And even before restrictions became obviously lifted to Italy, we were seeing a lot of interest on our website. So here's a snapshot of one of the offers we have right now on the Travelzoo website. It's good for travel October of this year through March of 2022. Round trip airfare out of Los Angeles. 6 nights at this place. It's called the Castello di Montegufoni in Tuscany. This is a beautiful property. You get a rental car for the duration of your stay. So you're cruising Tuscany, $899 per person. Not bad for these kinds of digs.
That's normally what it costs to rent a car in this country. So $899
exactly
for the whole
right.
thing. Yeah, I think that's a good deal.
Sign us up.
Hey, if we're in Italy, why not stop by Spain? What's in Spain?
Yeah, so Spain is actually probably the first or second destination in Europe that our members are booking on our website. Greece is up there as well. I love this resort because it's just outside Salamanca in Spain. It's called the Hacienda Sorita Wine Hotel. So they make a wine from their own grapes, their own property. They make cheeses from the milk of their own sheep and goats. So this is a very foodie-friendly destination. You're about 30 minutes outside of Salamanca, which itself is a beautiful Gothic, historic destination there in Spain. $169 a night for this place with breakfast daily. Again, five-star luxury. This is a 14th-century monastery, which is now a five-star hotel. And again, it speaks to the kind of value you're seeing on the other side of the pond, as they say.
Wow. Monastery turned hotel. Why not a castle?
I'll take it.
That'll do, right?
Exactly. And listen, we know that Ireland is opening up to Americans tomorrow. What kind of values are we seeing now to the Emerald Isle? This is from a company called Great Value Vacations. Again, airfare out of Los Angeles. You get out to Ireland and you get to stay in a variety of different abbeys and hotels, including this place. It's called the Abbey Hotel in Roscommon there in Ireland. You get a rental car for the duration of your stay, and it's for travel this fall through March of next year, pricing between $9.99 and $10.99, depending on when you go. And if you go in March, I might see you there, because after 2 long years, I think I finally get to go back to cover St. Patrick's Day in Ireland in March of next year. So join me, won't you? This is a great deal here through Great Value Vacations.
We want to see pics.
Hey, in addition to that, yeah. Gabe, thanks for dressing to the nines, man. We appreciate
Seriously.
It. Yeah, you got it, man. Great to see you guys. And if you haven't traveled internationally in a while, check your passport expiration date. For a lot of the destinations, you need an extra 6 months past your travel date. I'm hearing a lot of stories of folks who realize your passport is expired. So get on that.
Best tips, best deals from Gabe Saglie. Thanks so much. Hey, for more
Good
from
to see
Gabe,
you guys. Thanks.
And also access to the deals that you just heard about, visit the website. It's there at the bottom left part of your screen, travelzoo.com/TV. Thanks again, Gabe.
Very cool. He mentioned the Abbey. It was the Abbey, the monastery, or the castle.
Yeah.
Very different than the Abbey here in WeHo.
Oh, very different.
Which I love. Which I love.
Right.
You'll find me there.
Oh, absolutely. I was going to comment on his amazing jacket. It was like Anchorman style.
It was. It had little, was it like maroon?
Yeah, yeah.
Not maroon.
Pomegranate?
He said more Pinot Noir.
He said Pinot Noir. Burgundy.
Burgundy, a region of France,
tomato.
But you know, we were talking about Spain. You know, I always have to throw it out there. The rain in Spain stays mainly on the plain.
Mm-hmm.
Benumch.